Let's have a recap on our topic, chapter 5. This is design and analysis of members for compression. So, recap muna tayo, guys. So, dalawa lang naman yan. So, yung grupo is for doubly symmetric members. For doubly symmetric members, kapag aalamin natin kung without slender elements, the flexural buckling limit state will or is only applicable. Flexural buckling limit state. So kung with slender element, so kung with slender elements, dalawa kasi yan, pwedeng yung unstiffened element ang slender o di kaya yung stiffened element ang slender. Kapag ganito, may slender element sa doubly symmetric members, ang mangyayari diyan ang mag-govern ay yung flexural buckling limit state tsaka yung isa dito according to the NSCP. The other limit state is the torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state. Okay, kapag singly symmetric, unsymmetric, o di kaya built-up section on sa pati cruciform. Okay? So yung cruciform kasi is a doubly, yung doubly 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 symmetric member. Okay? So kapag without slender element, ang mag-govern yan na limit state will be the flexural buckling limit state and the torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state. Okay? Kahit without. So, take note ha, kasama yan. And kapag with slender element naman, mag-govern dyan will be, so pwedeng yung unstiffened o di kaya yung stiffened element rather, ang slender, so flexural buckling limit state ang mag-govern and the torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state. So dalawa yan. Okay, so let us now continue our discussion. So let us solve the next problem in here. Where is that? Chapter 5. So, I think we are through with this built-up section. Ito. Tapos na tayo dyan. So, ito na. So, a problem in double angle. So, verify the strength of a 2L 102 by 102 by 9.5 by 19 strut. So, double angle yan with a separator. ASTM A36 with a length of 2.5 meters and pinned at ends, carrying an axial load of 90 kilonewtons and live load of 250 kilonewtons. So, meron tayong mali. Okay. So, meron tayong column dito. Pinned at both ends. So, madali lang. Kung pinned at both ends, kaagad-agad yan, K is equal to 1.0. Pinned at both ends. So, the loads here, PD is equal to 90 kilonewtons and the live load is 250 kilonewtons. The section is 2L102 by 102 by 9.5 by 19. Okay. So 19 yan ha. Ay, sobra doon. So by 19. Okay. So exit muna natin to. Hanapin natin yung geometric properties. So, ganun din. Paulit-ulit lang yung procedure dito. Unang inaalam yung slenderness. Chine-check yung slenderness. At inaalam kung less than 200 kasi yun yung gustong mangyari ng NSCP. Whiteboard. Okay. So, ayan. So, ayan na ta. So, hanapin natin dito. Palitin ko lang ng konti. I hope nakikita nyo. Ayan. So, hanapin natin yung 2L102. L pa lang yan. 2L102 by 102 by 19. Yung may separator. Ito. 2L102 by 102 by 9.5 by 19. So, ito yung mga properties na kakailanganin natin. Medyo blurred yata. Okay, walang problem. Yan. So, unahin natin yung RX and RY kasi gagamitin natin mamaya sa slenderness check. Okay? So, geometric properties or section properties. Unahin natin yung RX. What would be the RX for this double angle here? Ayan yan. So that is 31.2 millimeters. What is RY? RY, you can see there, that is 49.3 millimeters. What else? Ang kailangan ko pa, the gross area. The cross-sectional area A, what's that? Sa baba. Ayan, 3690 square millimeter. And then the J, that is the torsional moment of inertia. Wala yan. Kaso nga lang, ang J for this one is 2 times the J of L102 by 102 by 9.5, yung single angle. So this is equal to, so you can use this table again, yung yung AISC. So hanapin natin yon. Haanin, mga baybayagan, okay? So the J for 102 by 102 by 9.5 is what? So wala pala akong okay, hanapin na lang natin. So for the single angle L102 yan, sidig matalaya 102 by 102 by 9.5 there you are. So yung J is 58.7. So 2 times 58.7 times 10 cube, so this is equal to ano, 117.4 times 10 cube millimeter to the fourth. Okay, so going back to the double angle 102 by 102 102 by 102 by 9.5 by 19. Okay, so ito yan. So take note, ha, hindi nakalagay yung J kada ti double angle, pero of course that is times 2 of the J, the torsional constant ng single angle. How about the flange width? The flange width for the angle is 102. So ganito yung ano, if this ganito yung double angle na ganyan, ito yung B. Okay? And this is the separator. Ito yung 19 mm. So B is 102 mm. Okay? And what else kailangan ko pa dyan is the thickness of the angle. The thickness is, tingnan, walang TF. Thickness ang meron kapag angle. Ayun, 9.53 millimeters. So those are the geometric properties or yung section properties for that double angle. So pwede na tayong magsimula katulad nung ginagawa natin sa kahit anong section, okay? Naghang na naman. Okay? So, anong gagawin natin? Eh, naghang na naman. Yan. So, ang una nating ginagawa dyan is so, dagdag na lang natin yung FY. What is FY? FY na given for the problem, sabi dyan is it's ASTM A36, yung FY is 250 megapascals for ASTM A36. And yung E, parati namang sa structural steel, this is 200,000 megapascals. So yan yung mga gagamitin natin na properties ng material. Okay? So yan, para mas malaki. So gawin natin dito is let us solve for the required compressive strength. Take note, sabi sa problem we will be using, di ba sinabi? So hindi naman sinabi kung LRFD or ASD, so gawin na lang natin pareho. So for the required compressive strength for LRFD, the PU, okay, PU is equal to 1.2 PD plus 1.6 PL. So this is equal to 1.2, the given PD is 90 kilonewtons plus 1.6 times 250 kilonewtons as live load. So this will be equal to 558 kilonewtons. And for ASD naman, yung PA natin is equal to PD plus PL. So that would be 90 plus 500, mali, 90 plus 250. So this is equal to 340 kilonewtons. Okay, so again, katulad lang din sa mga ibang na-discuss na natin, ang susunod dito is to check for slenderness. Okay? Slenderness ratio. So, yung susunod natin is slenderness ratio. Check natin kung less than 200, and malalaman natin dito kung ano yung mag-govern ng slenderness ratio. Okay? So, according to the problem, the Kx is equal to Ky pinned at pot end, so that is 1.0. The length Lx is equal to Ly. Ang length na nakalagay sa problem ay, according to the problem, this is 2.5 meters. 2.5 meters. So the length is 2.5 meters. And meron naman na tayong Rx and Ry. Unahin na natin yung Kx, Lx over Rx. Okay? So, KL over R along the X. So, this is equal to 1.0 times 2.5. Take note, yung Rx natin is in millimeters. So, convert ko to sa millimeters din. Divided by our Rx here is 31.2 millimeters. 31.2 millimeters. So, ang Kx Lx over Rx natin is 80.13. How about the other one? Yung Ky Ly over Ry is equal to 1.0 times, parehas lang naman yan, 2.5 times 10 cubed. Mag-iiba lang sa radius of gyration. Ang radius of gyration about the y-axis is this one, 49.3 millimeters. 49.3. So this is equal to 50.71. So this is less than 200. So this is okay. This is also is less than 200. This is okay. Gagawin ko lang dito is alamin ko kung ano yung mag-govern dito. Ano ba yung mag-govern dyan? Yung mas malaki. So therefore, KL over R is equal to 80.13. Kaya tayo, di nag-govern. Mas malaki yung value. And then, susunod dyan after solving for the slenderness ratio is to check for the slenderness of elements. So for the slenderness of elements here, so balikan lang natin ito, slenderness of elements. Ito. So both doon sa double angle natin, yung mga elements niya, they are unstiffen. So, nasaan yan? Ito yan. So, therefore, yung B over T must be less than 0.45 the square root of EFY para non-slender siya. Beyond that, it would be slender. Okay? So, what is B over T? So, yung B natin, kaya nga sinolve natin kanina, yung B natin is that one, yung T natin is that one. So, 102 over 9.53. So this is equal to 10.70. And yung lambda r according to the table is what? Eta. 0.45 square root of E over Fy. 0.45 times square root of E over Fy. So this is equal to 0.45 times square root of 200,000 over Fy. Ang Fy natin is 250 megapascals. So this is equal to 12.73. Okay, so 12.73 B over T, as you can see, so comparing these two values here, B over T is obviously less than lambda R, therefore no slender elements. So isa na lang yung kinuha ko, yung B over T compared to that lambda R, kasi parehas lang naman yan. Take note ha, kasi data. So this is B, this is also B, this is also B. So isolve ko mut lang T B over T na data, parehas lang dito sa B over T na na-compute ko dito. So iisa lang. Both naman ay unstiffened. Unstiffened yan. Unstiffened din to. Okay, so we found out that there is no slender element for the given section. So we can now solve for the nominal compressive strength. Balikan lang natin yung sinasabi sa NSCP. Ano ba sinasabi sa NSCP? So yung NSCP natin ay ito. Dito natin mahanap. So no slender element, without slender elements. So this section applies to singly symmetric and unsymmetric. Take note, yung double angle na yon is singly symmetric, it is symmetric along the y-axis. Okay? So the nominal compressive strength shall be determined based on the limit states of flexural, torsional, and torsional buckling as follows. Of course, aside from the first one, kasi, so for the nominal compressive strength here, so flexural buckling limit state is applicable. Okay? And torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state is also applicable. So unahin natin yung flexural torsional or flexural buckling muna. Flexural buckling limit state, yung dalawang limit states naman, parati naman yung PN is equal to FCR multiplied by AG. Okay, so nandito yan. So PN is equal to FCR multiplied by AG. The FCR is determined using this one. Natay, kita. So unahin muna nating alamin yung FE. So FE is equal to pi squared e over the governing KL over R squared. So this is equal to pi squared times 200,000 megapascals divided by our governing slenderness ratio is 80.13 squared. So this is equal to, ang Fe natin ay equal to 307.43 megapascals. And according to the NSCP, compare ko daw yung Fe sa 0.44 Fy. What is 0.44 Fy? So this is equal to 0.44 times 250 megapascals. So 0.44 times 250 is 110 megapascals. So by inspection, yung Fe is greater than 0.44 Fy. And according to the code, if that is the case, kung yung Fe is greater than 0.44 Fy, ito yung gagamitin nating formula for FCR. Therefore, FCR is equal to 0.658 raised to Fy over Fe multiplied by Fy. So this is equal to 0.658 raised to, what is Fy? Ang Fy natin is 250 divided by Fe, which is 307.43 multiplied by Fy is 250. So FCR is equal to 177.88 megapascals. So therefore, the Pn here, okay, the Pn is equal to FCR multiplied by Ag, 177.88 multiplied by what would be the Ag. The Ag is 3690 square millimeters. Yung Pn is 656.38 kilonewtons. Take note, ha? 656380 newtons yung sagot na mga kukuha dyan. Ginibide ko lang sa 1,000. Next, flexural buckling limit state. Applicable din yung torsional and nagpipatakjay tawag na torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state. And according to the code ulit, Pn is equal to FCR multiplied by Ag. Kaso nga lang, iba-iba yung pagkuha ng FCR. So first, for double angle and T-shaped compression members, ito yung gagamitin. So malamang yan yung gagamitin natin. Double angle yung kinoconsider natin. Okay? So again, FCR is equal to FCRY plus FCRZ divided by 2H times 1 minus square root of 1 minus 4FCRY FCRZ H over FCRY plus FCRZ squared. Okay? Yeah. So, alamin natin, ano yung mga unknowns na yun? FCRY. Anong problema ko yung FCRY? Ayan. FCRY is taken as FCR from equation 505.3-2 or 505.3-3. Okay? For flexural buckling amount of y-axis of symmetry, and KL over RY is equal to KL over RY. Okay? So, ang gagawin natin dyan is yung KL over R na gagamitin natin is yung KL over RY. Correct? FCRZ. Where is that? So, FCRY. Unahin ko yung FCRY. FCRY is equal to FCR daw. FCR doon sa section or sa equation 505.3-2. Ito eh. Nagito eh. Sa flexural buckling limit state. Or there. So, FCR in the previous. Okay? In flexural buckling limit state. Okay? So, this will be equal to ano yung FCR na nakuha na natin? FCR na nakuha natin is this one, 177.88. is 177.88. Tama ba? Ha, nagdapibagbaga na ito eh. So, dapat alam nyo lang kung ano mga pinagsasabi. For flexural buckling about the y-axis of symmetry and KL over R. KL over R is equal to KL over RY. So, yung ba yung ginamit natin na KL? So, I think hindi. Correct? KL over RY, this is etiquette RX. So, anong gagawin natin? So, solve ulit tayo. Pero, so, pwedeng ito yung gamitin. Pwede rin naman actually ito. Ito for single symmetric members or y-axis of, is the axis of symmetry. So, pwede yan ha. Yun yung ginamit sa handout. Pero, pwede rin naman gamitin ito. Okay? So, mali ito. So, let us solve for FE. FE, again, is equal to pi squared E over KLY over RY. Okay? So, KYLY over RY. So, this is equal to pi squared times 200,000 megapascals over 50.71, meron na pala tayo. So, sige lang, ulitin na lang natin. 49. This is 50.71. So, this is 50.71. And according to the code, ito daw yung gagamitin ko na KL over RY para sa FE para makuha ko yung FCR na to. So, mali kasi yan. Okay? So, FCRY is equal to, so, take note ha. FE, what is 0.44 FY? 0.44 FY is 110 megapascals. 110 megapascals. So, tila damot. Adi detay ah. So, KYLY over RY. Sumit lang ajay, apo. Nimaday. 50.71. This is 50.71. This is equal to, let's use our calculator. So pi squared times 200,000 divided by 50.71 is 71 squared. Is 767.61 megapascal. Still, Fe is greater than 0.44 Fy, so ang gagamitin pa rin natin na formula for FCR here is equal to 0.658 raised to Fy over Fe times Fy. So this is 0.658 times Fy is 250. Fe is 767.61 times 250. FCR. Pakitaan ko kayo ng ano ah. Kung paano ginagawa 'to. Ayan. So, ito. Solve natin to, ha? 0.658. So, oh no. 0.658 raised to 0.658 raised to Fy. Ang Fy natin is 250 divided by 767.61 multiplied by so times 250 megapascals. So ang sagot madi na gayon kaya nagpay sa datay. Okay, so sa calculator ko na lang. So, ang sagot dyan is 0.658 exponent 250 divided by 767.61 multiplied by 250 218 FCR is 218.14 megapascal. So, ito yung FCR na ilalagay ko doon sa FCRY. So, what's next? So, ang next dito is naglolo ko. So, meron na tayong FCRY. FCRY is equal to 218.14. FCRZ. According to the code, FCRZ is equal to that. GJ over FCRJ is GJ over AG R naught squared. Pero ano yung R naught squared for that one? So R naught is the polar radius of gyration about the shear center. So tingnan natin kung merong meron naman na tayong J, meron na tayong G. Of course, G is equal to, according to the code, that is 77,200 megapascals. Yung J, nandadon sa una natin kanina. So, how about R naught? Ayun, meron tayong R naught dito. Ito yung R naught na kailangan ko. 63.2. 63.2. Millimeters. So FCRZ is equal to 77,000 times 200. Tama ba ako ng ginagamit na G? 77,200. So 77,200 times the first page, yung hindi, second, fourth. Yan. Yung J is in here. Ito, J is 117.4. 117.4. 117.4 times 10. 10 cube. Okay? So that is GJ divided by 3690. AG is 3690. Yes, 3690 times yung R naught natin is 63.2 squared. So FCRZ is 77,200 times 117.4 exponent 3 divided by 3690 times 63.2 squared is 614.93 megapascals. So I can now solve for the FCR. Kasi sabi dito, the FCR will be computed like this. Pero ang hindi pa natin alam is yung H. What is H? H nasa AISC table din yan. And not H na for this. Ito, 0.856. 0.856 yung H. H is 0.856. FCR therefore is equal to, gamitin na natin ta. Okay. Equal to FCRY, which is 218.14 plus FCRZ, which is 614.93 divided by 2H, 2 times 0.856 times 1 minus square root ng 1 minus 4 times FCRY. FCRY is 218.14 times FCRZ is 614.93 times H 0.856 divided by FCRY is 218.14 plus FCRZ. FCRZ is 614.93. So FCR then is equal to 218.14 plus 614.93 divided by 2 times 0.856 times 1 minus the square root of 1 minus 4 times 218.14 times 614.93 times 0.856. Paki-double check na lang sa calculators nito. 218.14 plus 614.93, it's 203.62. Okay. Is 203.62 megapascals. That is the case. I can now solve for Pn. So this is simply FCR Ag. So this is 203.62 megapascals multiplied by 3690 square millimeters. So this is equal to 203.62 times 3690. So that would be 751357 or 751. So comparing the two PNs, therefore the governing PN will be the lesser, the smaller one. So anat PN tayo flexural buckling, yung PN natin is 656. So yun yung mag-govern. So that would be 656.38 kilonewtons. So that is the case. I can now solve for the available. For the available compressive strength, according to the code for LRFB, the available will be what? So for LRFB, the available will be this one, PN. So this is 0.9 times 656.38 times 656.38. So this one is 656.38 times 0.9. This will be 590.74 kilonewtons. So let us compare the sige, mamaya na. Yan na lang muna yan. So for ASD naman, ASD, so yung available o yung yes, the allowable no, for ASD is like this. So this is PC, correct? So this is 656, kasi ito naman yung nag-govern na PN natin, divided by 1.67, that is the omega C for compression. 656.38 divided by 1.67, that would be 393.04 kilonewtons. Yan yung mga available. And checking now for the adequacy, kasi pinapacheck yung adequacy ah. So let us compare the allowable, which is PN, is equal to 590.74 kilonewtons. Compare it to PU, which is the required. So our PU is, number 3 lang pala yun. Our PU four. Our PU is this. Not mabasa. So our PU is 1 PU, balikan ko lang ah. Ang PU natin is 558. So the PU is 558. Eksakto nga 558 kilonewtons. So mas malaki naman yung available, therefore the section is safe or adequate. Okay? So for ASD naman 393.04 kilonewtons compared to PA, which happens to be 340 kilonewtons. Mas malaki yung yung available kaysa dun sa required. So therefore the section is safe. Okay, so let us now go to the next problem. So dito iba yung procedure, ha? Pero parehas lang din naman. Okay, dito sa torsional and flexural torsion. Take note, ang ginamit dito is yung FPY, pero parehas lang. Medyo may konting discrepancy lang yung mga sagot. Okay? Pero mas maganda kasing gamitin ito, yung una. Yung ko lang na-realize kasi. For double angle and T-shape, kunana natin. So double angle yung sinasolve natin. Ito yung Matt Banger, ito yung ginamit natin. For all other cases, shall be determined according. So pinilit na gamitin yung ito, singly symmetric members where Y is the axis of the symmetry. So pwede rin yan, parang. Pero mas maganda gamitin dahil may special provision naman dito for double angle and T-shape. Ito yung gagamitin ko in solving for FCR. So ito, ano pang ginamit ba ulit dito? Oh, ganun ulit yata. Ay, hindi. Okay. So ito. So determine if at 2L, parehas lang din yan. Okay? May... Okay, sige. Solve rin natin to. Determine if a 2L127 by 76 by 6.4 by 19. Take note, LLBB strut. Kunana, kapag hindi kasi parehas yung legs, meron ng designation yan na letter LLBB at yung iba pa. So, so with a length of 2.5 meters and pin at 10 millibar support, dead load of 45 and light load of 135 in axial compression. So ganun din. So meron tayo ditong ayan, pin at both ends. So K is equal to 1. The length is 2.5 meters. So ito yung PD is equal to 45 kilonewtons. PL is equal to 135 kilonewtons. ASTM A36. FY is equal to 250 megapascals. Ang gagamitin natin na section is 2L127 by 76 by 6.4 by 19. May separator ulit to. Okay? So, ano? So, section properties muna. Section properties, gusto kong ipakita sa inyo kung nasaan yung mga yon. So, section properties. L127 mga LBB. Ayan, mga LLBB. Okay? 2L127. By 76. 127 by 76 by 6.4 by 6.4 by 19. Ayan. So, ito yung mga section properties niya. Ano yung mga section properties na gagamitin natin? Unahin natin yung Rx. So, Rx is equal to, nakikita nyo naman dyan, that is 41.1 millimeter. Yung Ry equals 49.3 millimeters. Ano? Rx 10 sa baling tikit kita. Okay, then Ry is 33.8 millimeters. What else? So for the gross area, gagamitin natin yan for sure. Gross area is 2,500 square millimeters. Napay? The J is equal to 2. Wala ang J ito, ang global angle. Pero yung single angle meron. So, 2 times 18.2 times 10 cube. This is equal to 36.4. 36.4 times 10 cube millimeter to the fourth. So yan pa lang muna yung alamin natin. But of course, we can always write the B and the T. B is 76.2 millimeters and its thickness is, where is the thickness? Nasa taas yata yung thickness is 6.35. Thickness is 6.35 millimeters. Then after solving for the, after knowing for the suction properties, so what should we do next? So, ito na. Sige. So, anong gagawin natin? Maximize ko na lang to. Ano ba yung na-maximize? So, the thickness. Then, we shall now solve for the required compressive strength here. Required compressive strength. Yun naman kasi sinabi kung LRFD or ASD. So, dalawa na lang. For LRFD, PU is equal to 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. So, this is 1.2 times 45 plus 1.6 times 135 kilonewtons. So, the PU is 270 kilonewtons. And for ASD, PA is equal to simply PD plus PL. So, that is 45 plus 135. So, that is 180 kilonewtons. Okay? So, after solving for the required strength, So we shall now solve for the slenderness ratio and check the slenderness ratio kung less than 200 or less, yes, less than 200 yung slenderness ratio. So first kx lx over rx, so pare-parehas lang naman yan, yung kx is 1.0, yung lx is 2.5 times 10 cubed divided by the radius of gyration, which is 41.1 along the x. So this is equal to 60.83. And yung ky, ly over ry, so pinpind 1.0, ly is 2.5 meters divided by the radius of gyration about the y-axis is 33.8. This is equal to 74.01. They are both less than 200. Less than 200 yan. So, okay ito. Okay yan. Then, the governing KL over R therefore is equal to 74.01. Yan yung mas malaki kasi. And after that, paulit-ulit lang, slenderness of elements. Ito na, hindi na parehas yung legs. So, slenderness of elements. So, check natin yung dalawa. Okay? Slenderness of elements. Dalawang unstiffened to. So, unahin natin yung 127 mm leg. Kasi gamit itsura na data. Kasalatan. The separator na. So, double angle siya na data ikit 76. 76 mo tabang yan. And this one is 127. Okay? So, ang yan yung i-check natin ng mga slenderness. Yung unahin na natin yung 127 mm. Both unstiffened. So, for the 127 mm leg, so, B over T, B over T is, take note, medyo may, baka may kaguluhan dito. Dalawa to ah. 76.2 millimeters. So, hindi natin gagamitin ito. Yes. So, dalawa yung B. Hindi lang yan yung gagamitin natin. What I mean. Okay. So, yung 127, kung gusto mong i-ano, kung eksaktong 127 yon, balikan natin to. So, wala ba siyang nilagay na BF? So, 120B. Ayan, 76.2. Ken, adapi may isa dapat. Wala na siyang nilagay. Then, that D. 127 eksakto. 76.2 yung isa. Okay? So, 76.2 and 76.2 and 127 eksakto. So, the B is 76.2 and 127 eksakto millimeters. Yan yung mga legs. That is for the legs. So, unahin natin yung 127 millimeter leg. So, that is 127 divided by the thickness is, so, in the handout, I assume na 6.4, pero inamit natin, this is 6.35. So, yan yung gamitin natin. Divided by 6.35. So, this is equal to 127 divided by 6.35. That is exactly equal to 20. And ano yung ginagamit natin for lambda r here? lambda r 0.45 is 0.45 for angles, square root of e over fy. So this is 0.45 times square root of 200,000 divided by fy is 250, and that would be 0.45 12.73. So comparing b and b over t here, b over t is obviously greater than lambda r. Therefore, the 127 mm leg is slender. Okay, so slender yung 127 millimeter leg. And how about for the other? For the another yung isang leg tayon? For the 76. Exactly 76.2 millimeter leg. Tama ba? 76.2 millimeter leg. So b over t is equal to 76.2 divided by 7.35 is equal to 76.2 divided by 7.35 is equal to 10.37. And comparing it to lambda r, ganyan ito rin yung lambda r. So here b over t is less than 12.73, therefore the 76.2 millimeter leg is non-slender. So meron tayong slender unstiffened element here. So paano natin gagamit? Balikan natin yung NSCP. According to the NSCP, kapag meron kang slender na unstiffened, NSCP 505 ito. Okay. So ito, members with slender elements. This section applies to compression members with slender sections, as defined in yan. Nalaman natin na may slender. The nominal compressive strength, PN, shall be determined based on the limit states of flexural, torsional, and flexural. So, dalawa yung limit states na gagamitin natin. Okay? So, for the nominal compressive strength, for the nominal compressive strength, unahin natin yung dalawa naman na limit state yan, di ba? So, flexural buckling limit state. Flexural buckling limit state. So, paano ginagawa yung flexural buckling limit state? Ito, nag-iiba. Pn is equal to FCR AG. Walang pagkakaiba pa rin naman yan. Pagkakaiba lang yan, ay yung mga yan, meron ka na nakikitang Q. Okay? So, Q, paano kinukuha yung Q? Sabi dyan, Q is equal to 1.04 members with compact and non-compact. Ibig sabihin non-slender sections as defined for uniformly compressed elements. And QSQA for members with slender element. So, ito, user note. Maganda tong user note na to. For cross sections composed of only unstiffened slender elements, QA is equal to 1, then Q is equal to QS. So, ibig sabihin, for unstiffened slender element, so Q is equal to QS. So, hanapin ko yung QS ngayon. So, QS is unknown. So, saan hahanapin yan? The reduction factor QS for slender stiffened element is defined as follows. Okay? So, for flanges, angles, and plates projecting from rolled, ayan, ito naman, projecting from built up, this is for single angle, this is for stems of this, So unstiffened, ah. So ito yan. For plunges, angles, for rolled columns. So hanapin natin yung Q. So what is B over T? Solving now for QS, what is B over T? So I had solved already B over T for the slender one, ah. So yung slender natin is yung 127 millimeters, thickness is equal to 6.35 millimeters. Yan yung slender natin na unstiffened element. So ang B over T natin is this one. Ito ay pang slender. B over T is 20. Ano pa yung kukuhanin? 0.56 square root of E over Fy. So this is 0.56 square root of 200,000 over 250 megapascals. Okay, so wala sa notes na nabura yung sa limit state for, ay hindi, meron pala. So 0.56 flexural buckling. Ano, bakit ganito yung nakalagay dito? So palitan ko mamaya yung nasa handa. So 0.56, bakit 0.64 ginamit sa handout? Saan yan? Ay, ito. For built up. Mali, hindi naman yan built up. Okay. Built up ba ito? Hindi naman siya built up, guys. Rolled columns or other compression members for plunges, angles, and plates projecting from built-up columns or other. So I considered it a built-up. Okay. Okay. So this is a built-up one. Bubura na. So 0.64. Ito, sa built up tayo, guys. For plunges, angles, and pitch projecting from a built. Yes. So this is equal to 15.78 and another one 1.17. So 1.17 square root of EKC over FY. Pero what is KC? KC is equal to 4 over, according to the code data, 4 over the square root of H over TW. So this is equal to 4 over the square root of, ano yung H niya? So H is J leg. Ganyan yan, diba? Na tinukot H. So that would be That is 76.2 to be exact. 76.2 millimeters divided by TW is this one. So, paano natin kukunin yung TW na yan? So, TW is equal to the separator, which is 19 millimeters, plus 2 times the thickness is 6.35. The TW na gagamitin natin for that is 19 plus 2 times 6.35. That is 31.7 millimeters. So that is 31.7 millimeters. So ano yan? 4 divided by square root of 76.2 divided by 31.7. That is 2.58. Case is 2.58, sabi dito, and shall not be taken less than 0.35 nor greater than 0.76. So this is greater than 0.76, therefore KC is equal to 0.76. So here, 1.17 times square root of 200,000 times 0.76 divided by 250 is equal to 28.85. So according to the code, yung B over T nasa gitna ba nung dalawang yan? So yung B over T is 20. Yes, 20. Yes. So therefore, QS nasa gitna ah. Okay, ito 20 kat nasa gitna nito. Adati dati 20. So ibig sabihin, ito yung mag-govern. This one will govern here. Highlight na lang natin. Ito yung mag-govern. Correct? So, nasa gitna siya. So, ibig sabihin, ito yung QS na gagamitin ko. So, QS is equal to 1.415 minus 0.65 times B over T is 20 times square root of FY, it's 250 over 0.76, 200,000 E times 0.76. So QS is equal to 0.892. Okay? So going back now, kadatoy, alamin ko na ngayon yung FE, kung anong gagamitin ko dyan na formula in solving for FCR. Take note, flexural buckling pa lang to. So, FE is equal to pi squared E over the governing KL over R squared. So, this is equal to pi squared times 200,000 divided by ang nag-govern na KL over R is 74.01 squared. And the answer for FE is 360.37 megapascal. Now, comparing it to 0.44 FY kanina. Pero ngayon, it's now Q FY. Take note ah, yung Q natin, according to the code, Q is equal to QS. That is equal to 0.892. Kapag merong, ang meron lang is slender, unstiffened. So, ito. Magakpay lang ito. So, is equal to 0.44 times the Q is 0.892 times 250, therefore 0.44 QFY is 98.12 megapascals. Now, comparing it, yung FE is obviously greater than 0.44 QFY, and according to the code na naman, the formula for FCR, if that is the case, is this one. Neta. Okay? So, FE is greater than 0.44 QFY. So, that would be Q times 0.658 raised to QFY over FE multiplied by FY. So, this is equal to 0.892 times 0.658 raised to 0.892 multiplied by 250 divided by yung FE natin na na-solve is 360.37 multiplied by 250. And the computed FCR is equal to, can you use your calculators? FCR is 172.12 megapascals. Now, I can now solve for PN. This is just simply FCR multiplied by AG. So, this is 172.12 megapascals multiplied by 2,500 square millimeters. So PN is therefore 430 kilonewtons. That is for the flexural buckling limit state. How about the other limit state? The torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state. So sa isang limit state pa. So nasaan 'yon? So kung ito yung gagamitin natin for flexural torsional, for flexural buckling, nasa man naman yung flexural torsional. So nandito dito siya. Okay, ganun din yung gagawin natin for this one. Okay. So flexural buckling yung isa, ito naman yung torsional and flexural buckling of members limit state. So PN then is equal to FCR AG. Okay? Pero alin diyan yung gagamitin natin na formula? Ito double angle ulit. For double angle and T-shaped compression members. Okay, so FCR. So FCR, masasolve ko naman yung FCR. FCR is equal to FCRY plus FCRZ. Yung ginawa natin kanina, 2H times 1 minus the square root of 1 minus 4FCRY. Sa isa lang natin alamin yung mga to. FCRZ times H divided by FCRY plus FCRZ squared. Yan. Again, FCRY. Ano yung FCRY? Sabi dito, FCRY. Ulitin ko lang yung nasabi na kanina. FCRY can be taken as FCR from equation 505.3-2 or 505.3-3 for flexural buckling about the y-axis of symmetry, and KL over R is equal to KL over RY. Okay? So, KL over RY. Yung ba yung nag-govern? Maganda kung yun yung nag-govern. KL over RY. Ayun, siya yung nag-govern. So, ibig sabihin, yun na mismo yung gagamitin natin. Okay? So KL over RY naman yung nag-govern. So this is FCR dun kan sa kanina sa in flexural buckling. Provided yung gagamitin daw na KL over R, KL over R is KL over RY, which is 74.01. Medyo agkamali. 74.01. Okay, so tama. So yun naman, ito naman yung ginamit natin. So ibig sabihin, FCRY is equal to FCR na kaagad. Yun na mismo, ito eh. 172.12 megapascals. So FCRZ is equal to GJ over AG R naught squared. So G is equal to 77,200 megapascals. J, yan naman natin. Yung R naught, yung hanapin natin. R naught. R naught. 65.8 millimeters. 65.8 millimeters. 65.8 millimeters. Okay? And hanapin din naman natin yung H na. Yay, H niya. So what is H? Hanapin din natin doon. Balikan lang natin yung AISC. Yung H is this one. Jumbo-jumbo gamin. There, 0.657. 0.657. 0.657. So that is the H. So I can now solve for FCRZ. So FCRZ is equal to JG, correct? GJ. So the G is 77,200 megapascals multiplied by the torsional moment of inertia. The torsional moment of inertia is 36.4 times 10 cube millimeter to the fourth over AGR naught squared. The gross sectional area is 2,500 square millimeters times the R naught. R naught is 65.8. So FCRZ is 259.61 megapascals. Meron na akong FCRY, meron na akong FCRZ. Masasal ko na yung FCR. FCR is equal to, yan dito yung formula niya, yan. Is equal to FCRY, which is 172.12 plus FCRZ is 259.61 divided by 2H, 2 times H, 0.657 times 1 minus the square root of 1 minus 4 times FCRY is 172.12 times 259.61 times 0.657 divided by FCRY is 172.12 plus FCRZ is the 259.61 squared. So FCR then is equal to 128.71 megapascal. So therefore PN is equal to, ulitin ko, this is FCR multiplied by AG. This is 128.71 times 2500. This is equal to 321.70 kilonewtons. So the governing PN, madali lang naman hanapin yung governing nominal strength. So for flexural buckling limit state, PN is equal to, PN is equal to 430 kilonewtons. For torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state, the PN is equal to this one, 321.78 kilonewtons. Therefore, the governing PN, ang gagamitin ko na PN is 321.78 kilonewtons. Ito kasi yung mas maliit. And now for the available compressive strength. Available compressive strength, unahin natin for LRFB, simple lang naman, yun mismo yung PCPN. So this is 0.9 times 321.78, that is 289.60. and for ASD, the available is PN divided by omega C. So this is 321.78 divided by 1.67. This is equal to 190.68 kilonewtons. Okay? And for the adequacy of the section, let us compare for LRFD yung PCPN, which happens to be 289.60. Compare it to the required compressive strength for LRFD, which happens to be 270 kilonewtons. So mas malaki ito, so therefore section is adequate for LRFD. For ASD naman, of course, the available compressive strength is this one, which happens to be 192.68 kilonewtons. Compare it to the required strength for ASD, which is 180 kilonewtons. Mas malaki pa rin to, so therefore section is adequate or safe. Okay, so that's all. Let us move to the next problem here. Problem 5.9.7. So sabi dito, select an ASTM A992. So this is a design problem, pero ang diskarte sa design dito is magpo-propose tayo ng section, then we will analyze it. Kung adequate naman siya, then we will adapt. Okay? So, A992 WT shape. Compression member with a length of 6 meters to support a dead load of 30 kilonewtons and a live load of 75 kilonewtons in axial compression. So, take note again. So, huwag kayo masyadong masanay dito. Ah. So, almost lahat ng examples ko, pin at both ends. Baka mabigla kayo kapag hindi na siya pinned at both ends. 6 meters yung length. So this is 6 meters. So the PD is 30 kilonewtons. PL is 75 kilonewtons. So ano pa yung given? So E is parati namang 200,000 megapascals. The Fy for this type of material A992 is 345 megapascals. 345 megapascals. Yung G, modulus of rigidity, is fixed naman sa 77,200. This is according to the NSCP. So WT. So first here, I will try WT 180 by 22. Okay, so I will try WT 180 by 22. So anong unahin natin? So section properties muna. Section properties for WT. Ay, wala yun. To the right, and of course ito. Okay? For section properties of that WT, hanapin natin dito. WT 180. WT 180 by 22. Ayan, magaan lang to. Ayan, 180 by 22. So ito yung mga section properties niya. Ano ba yung mga kailangan ko sa the gross area? The gross area for WT 180-22 is in here 2850 square millimeters. Anapay RX and RY. RX equals 52.6 millimeters. RY equals, where is RY? Matumiwalay siya. Ayan, 37.8 millimeters. The polar moment of inertia, J, meron bang ba? Yes, 79.1. In case magagamit natin, times 10 cube, 79.1 times 10 cube millimeter to the fourth. What else? So this is the overall depth. So kung meron tayong ganito, let it D. D is equal to 176 mm. Thickness of the web. Obviously, ito yung thickness ng web. Thickness ng web is there, 6.86 mm. Thickness ng flange, obviously ito. Thickness ng flange, yan, 9.78. Ano pa, neti base here. So BF. So BF natin is yung hole is 171 millimeters. Okay, so BF is 171 millimeter. And H, baka sakali. H is simply 176 minus thickness ng flange. Pero, ay hindi. Yung H is the D. Sa pagdating sa T-beams. Game. So after the section properties, we shall now solve for the slenderness ratio. Slenderness ratio. Wala namang bracing. KXLX over RX. Pinned at both ends. So KX is equal to KY is equal to 1.0 times 6 meters. 6 meters yung length. So 6 times 10 cube divided by RX. Ang RX natin ay 52.6 millimeters. So KXLX is over RX is equal to 114.07. How about the other slenderness ratio? KYLY over RY is 1.0 times 6 times 10 cube divided by yung RY is 37.8. So this is equal to 158.73. Checking this, the slenderness ratio, they are both less than 200, so okay yan. Less than 200 din to, so okay lang din. And then the governing KL over R then is equal to this. This will govern, so siya yung mas malaki, 158.73. So again, slenderness of elements. Both unstiffened, yung flange man o yung flange man o yung web. Okay, so hanapin natin dito. Maganda kapag nakikita nyo to. Okay, so slenderness of elements, hanapin natin dito. So nasaan yung T? So ito yung sinasabi ko, ah, ito yung duwad to yun, eh. They are under the, dapat unstiffened sila. So that ay T o sa rec. So sa stem unstiffened dito. Ken, that ay may isa. How about the flange? Unstiffened yung flange. Data ay take on up. Pananan. Yung may end other. Data. Uniform compression in legs of single angles, legs of double angles, with separators and all other unstiffened elements. So, that is yung end other. So, unahin natin yung web. Yung web is the stem. Ito yung web. Para sa web. Ito. Okay. For the web, this is case. Makikita yung matan? Case 8. Okay? So case 8, D can TW. D over TW is equal to, take note, yung D is the overall depth. So D over TW The D is 176. Millimeters divided by the thickness of the web is 6.86. D over TW is 25.66. And in case 8, ang sinasabi dyan sa case 8, nito ay, yung lambda R is equal to 0.75 square root of E over Fy. So this is 0.75 square root of 200,000 divided by Fy natin is 345 megapascals. So this is 18.06. So from here, D over TW is greater than lambda R. Therefore, the web is slender. It's very important to know that whether the element is slender or not para alam natin kung anong gagamitin natin ng mga formulas in computing for the nominal compressive strength. And for the stem, ay tama, for the stem na yan, for the web, for the flange ang gagamitin natin will be this one detay and all other unstiffened elements. For the flange, B over T is equal to, take note, yung B na nakalagay dito is the whole B. Okay? Ito yung BF. Okay? So, yung whole yan. Whole flange. Pero dito sa NSCP, yung B na ipapagamit is just half. Okay? So, half niya. So, B is one half ng B F divided by the thickness ng flange. Okay? So, this is one half ng 171 divided by thickness ng flange is 9.78. Thickness ng flange is 9.78. So, this one, B over T is equal to 8.74. And what would be the lambda R? Lambda R is equal to 0.45 times the square root of E over Fy. 0.45 times the square root of 200,000 divided by 345. This is equal to 10.83. So comparing now B over T is less than lambda over R for the flange. Therefore, the flange is non-slender. So, hindi slender element yung flange. So, ano ulit? Kapag merong isang both unstiffened, di ba? Kapag merong isang slender element, ito yung gagamitin natin. Pag nalaman mong may slender element na, dito ka na pumunta sa section 505.7, members with slender elements. And kapag isa lang ay kapag unstiffened yung slender, ito yung gagamitin natin. With unstiffened slender element. So, if this is the case, mag-govern yung flexural buckling limit state and torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state. Okay? Kailangan ko lang alamin yung Q. Q is equal to QS kapag merong unstiffed slender element. Okay? So I hope meron akong example kung saan meron ding Stephen ni nalabtawaksan. Pag-iaral na lang yan. I think yung prior to this, yung ginabtawak pa ikit. Wala ata akong example nun kung saan. Ay man, meron. Meron tayo supuli. Flash blended. Ay, meron naman na tayong example sa Slender Stephen. Okay, let us continue. Q is equal to QS, kanak. So, ano ba yung, paano natin i-compute yung QS? Okay? So, QS, ayun. Ano ba yung four stems of this? Kanak. So, ano ba yung Slender? Yung stem, tama. So, pwede, gamitin natin to. Okay? So, four stem of four stems of this when dt d over t, what is d over t? D over t para sa stem is na dandi dito. D over t sa stem is that 125.66 is less than 0.75. No, ito rin yung ginamit natin kanina kasi 0.75 to know whether the element is slender or not. So ano yung sagot? 18.06. Obviously, mas malaki yan. So hindi yung QS equals 1. So the other one, tingnan natin yung 1.03. How about 1.03 square root ng E over Fy? It's equal to 1.03 square root of 1.03 square root of 200,000 over 345. So this is equal to 1.03, that is 24.8. So compare natin. So in between na ba siya? Yes, hindi pa. So ang nangyari diyan is, ang nangyari diyan is yung d over t pala is greater than 1.03 square root of E over Fy. Therefore, what is QS? QS is equal to 0.69E divided by Fy times D over T squared. So this is equal, tama ba? Yes, that is correct. So QS then is equal to 0.69 times 200,000 divided by Fy is 345 times D over T. Ano ti D over T natin? 25.66. 25.66 QS is equal to calculators. So QS is equal to 0.608. Take note, yung QS pati yung QA pag Stephen Slender element, they are reduction factors yung mga yan. So meron na akong QS. So punta na tayo sa flexural buckling limit state. So after that, so alamin na natin yung mga ito. Balikan na natin. So meron na tayong QS, okay? So ito na siya. Ito. for flexural buckling limb state. Okay, so for flexural buckling limb state, again, yung nominal compressive strength PN is equal to FCR AG. Yung FCR lang yung hindi natin mahanap dyan kaagad-agad. So, hanapin ko muna yung FE. FE is equal to pi squared E over KL over R squared, the governing KL over R. So, this is pi squared times 200,000 divided by ang governing KL over R natin ay 158.73 squared. So yung FE natin for this one is 92, ay hindi, ano yung FE? FE is 78.35. 78.35 megapascals. So after solving for FE according to this one, so FE compare ko sa 0.44 QFY. So 0.44 QFY, but Q happens to be QS. 0.44 times 0.608 times 345 is equal to what? So 92.29 megapascals. So by inspection here, FE is less than 0.44 QFY. Therefore, the formula for FCR according to the code, kapag mas maliit, ito, FE is less than 0.44 QFY, ito daw yung gagamitin natin. FCR is equal to 0.877 FE. So, FCR then is equal to 0.877 times what is the computed FE? 78.35. 78.35. So this is equal to FCR is equal to 68.71 megapascals. So now yung PN for flexural buckling limit state, sabi ko nga kanina, it's FCR AG. So this is 68.71 times the area is 2,850 square millimeters. So the answer here is 195.82. So this is 195,820 newtons yung lalabas. Pero i-divide ko sa 1,000 para kilonewtons. So that is the nominal compressive strength for flexural buckling limit state. How about for torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state? So for torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state, and dito siya, ayan, ta. So for double angle NT, ayan, pwede na naman yan. For double angle and T-shaped compression members, ito yung gagamitin natin. So, ayan. So, PN again here is equal to FCR AG. Paulit-ulit lang yan. Kaso nga lang, yung FCR, iba yung style sa pagsasolve. So, this will be FCRY plus FCRZ divided by 2H times 1 minus square root ng 1 minus 4 FCRY FCRZ times H divided by FCRY plus FCRZ squared. So, same dilemma doon sa kanina. Paano natin isosolve yung mga yan? Yung FCRY, again, sabi dito, FCRY is taken as FCR from equation 505.3 and 505.3.3-3, where in KL is equal to KL over RY. So, balikan lang natin kung yung KL over R natin is KL over RY. If that is the case, then kukopyahin ko na lang to. If not, magre-recompute tayo. Papalitan natin yung pag-compute natin ng FE. Palitan ko yan. Ito, yung KL over R na ginamit natin is KL over RY. So, balikan ko lang kung ano yung nag-govern. Yung nag-govern is over RY. KYLY over RY. So, very good yan. Kasi, ang FCRY natin, FCRY natin is equal to FCR doon sa previous, doon sa flexural. In flexural buckling limit state. So, this is equal to eto, data pila ang 68.71 megapascal. So, yan. May nasolve na tayo. Napakadali pa lang isolve. Okay? So, how about FCRZ? FCRZ, andiyan naman yung formula. Ito. That is GJ over AG R naught squared. Ang hindi ko lang alam dyan is R naught squared. So, R naught is equal to, hanapin natin dito sa R naught. Tumpingin namin dito in list na ito. Ayan, 73.7. R naught is 73.7 millimeters. Hahanapin ko din naman yung H. Sige lang. Hanapin na rin natin yung H. Yung H is 0.772. H also is 0.7772. So, 0.772. So, this one is what? FCRZ. GJ. What is G? 77,200 times the moment of polar moment of inertia, torsional anat kahit na nga sa unti J yan, guys. J is the torsional constant, okay? So saan yon? Ito. So sa J 79.1 times 10 cubed divided by the total area, cross-sectional area is 2850 times R naught is 73.7 squared. So this is equal to FCRZ is 394.47 megapascals. So, meron na akong FCRY and FCRZ. So, I can now compute for FCR using the formula FCR is equal to FCRY. What is FCRY? 68.71 plus FCRZ. FCRZ is 394.47 divided by 2H. 2 times yung H natin is 0.772, correct? H natin is 0.772. So, over 2H times 1 minus square root of 1 minus 4 times FCRY 68.71 times 394.47 times H. What would be H? 0.772. Sa 0.772 dito. 0.772. Yes. Ano ka de pa gordera? Sorry. Laureate. Okay. Yan lang. Ano bang Laureate? Chicken? No, da sa bali ako ma. Siyang, yung sweet and sour. Divided by, kakain na ako. Divided by FCRY. What is FCRY? 68.71 plus 394.47 squared. Okay? So, using your calculators here, FCR happens to be 65.72 megapascals. So, I can now solve for the nominal strength. Pn is equal to, take note, it's FCR multiplied by Ag. So, this is 65.72 multiplied by the area, which is 2850. This is equal to 187.30 kilometers. Paulit-ulit na lang. Paano pipiliin yan? Kung anin mag-govern. The governing PN is the mas maliit. Governing PN is, ano ba? Sa flexural buckling limit state, ano yung PN? Flexural buckling limit state, ang PN natin ay 195.82. 195.82. Okay, so 195.82 Madeng. Katapos na tayo. So, ayaw lang mag so, for this one, yung PN is yan, pwede na. So, alamin lang natin kung alin ang mag-govern dito. So, for the flexural buckling limit state, balikan lang natin yung flexural buck, that is 195.82 kilonewtons. And for the torsional and flexural torsional buckling limit state, ang PN is this one, yung kakakompute lang natin, 187.30 kilonewtons. Therefore, ang mag-govern dyan, PN will be equal to 187.30 kilonewtons. Ganyan lang yan. Pipiliin mo lang dito kung alin ang mas maliit. Okay, so yun yung mag-govern. And for the available, ulit-ulit lang naman, available compressive strength so for LRFD that would be PC PN. So this is 0.9 times 187.30. This is equal to 168.57 kilonewtons. And for ASD naman, So yung available will be Pn divided by omega c. So this is 187.30 divided by 1.67. So this is equal to 112.16 kilonewtons. And next will be, what would be to determine the adequacy, kung safe yung section or not. So adequacy of section. So we will just compare, we will simply compare the available, which is for LRFD. So adequacy na to, ah. So for adequacy LRFD, we will simply compare the values yung available, which is PCPN, which happens to be 168.57. Compare it to the required PU. PU is for LRFD, which happens to be, ang PU natin, ibalikan natin sa una, it's 156 kilonewtons. So mas laki ito. So the available is mas malaki. Okay? So therefore section is adequate or safe. Section is safe. For ASD naman, I will compare the available for ASD. This is PN over omega C. This is 112.16, and compare it to PA, that is the required compressive strength, that is 105 kilonewtons. So greater than yan, so therefore section is also safe. and that concludes our discussion in chapter 5. For the other problem, the last problem here is a very simple one. Paki-check na lang. This is an HSS. So, stiffened yung dalawang yan. Meron bang slender dito? Not slender. So, napakadali lang naman yung example. Walang slender. So, ibig sabihin, this one is a problem in doubly symmetric. Symmetric siya sa y-axis, symmetric siya sa x-axis. So, dapat isa lang yung magagamit natin. Ayan, isa lang yung mag-govern na limit state, the flexural buckling limit state. Okay, so that's all. Thank you for listening.